Hi mommies, this is Tanya, Noor's mom. So today I'm going to be speaking about and showing you how to sterilize baby bottles. So all of you who are formula feeding their babies or are even using bottles for express milk, it's very vital that you sterilize them. Babies' bottles need to be sterilized till at least 1 year of age. And first you need to clean them with baby friendly bottle cleaning liquid, and only then you need to sterilize them. So earlier traditionally our mothers used to boil our bottles. So if you have the time and resources, you can still do that. That works equally. But with us millennial moms, I think we're always after saving time. So a steam sterilizer works best for it. So I'll quickly show you one round of how I sterilize her bottles. So this is one of her bottles that I need to clean and sterilize. So what I do is, if I have time, I will take a bowl and fill it with RO water, not the tap water, and I will put this baby liquid cleanser here. So I'm using the Mother Sparsh natural baby liquid cleanser. I was earlier using Pigeon, but I like this more. So what I do is, you can just take like one or two drops of it and soak the bottles in this if you have time. If you don't have time, no problem. Directly take the liquid on the brush and you need to start washing them. So you take a bottle brush. These are the Dr. Brown's bottle that I have spoken to you about. So you clean them properly from inside. Make sure you clean their rim also, right? Then this is the bottle fastener, so I clean that. And there's a bottle cap which I forgot to soak. Yeah, this is the bottle cap, so I will clean that also. As I had mentioned, this bottle has an anti-colic system. It's a vent, so for this a special brush is given by Dr. Brown's. So this is the brush. So how I clean it is that I clean this funnel here using this brush, and this is their vent actually. So I clean it from here so that there's no residue left inside which can harm the baby later. Sterilization is really important because the baby's digestive system is very, very fragile right now. It's developing, and we cannot let any kind of bacteria go to their mouth, because that can lead to an infection. So now that you see that I've cleaned them with soapy water, there are also a few pacifiers of hers. This is again Dr. Brown's, and I have a couple of teethers. You don't need to brush them or anything, just soak them in water would do. So once they are clean, then I will just drain this water out like this, and I will again wash them with RO water, not the tap water, because this water is more purified than our tap water, we all know that. So I will again wash them, just rinse them out, and once that's done, I will go to my sterilizer. So this is my Philips Avon sterilizer. This can take up 6 bottles at one time. So all you need to do is, you need to pick this up like this, and in case, so there's some water left from my previous sterilization. So there's this place here where you can put a little water. You can put any RO water. I'm just using my kettle. It needs to be plain room temperature water. Then I'll put this back again, and as you can see, there's a lot of space inside. So 6 bottles can come at a go. So I will put the rinse bottles here. So all the tall stuff I'll put here, and I'll also put her teethers here. This is the Dr. Brown's teether. These are some of the Kiko teethers. I'll make a video on teethers separately. And there's a top shelf where you can put all the caps and the nipples. It's a pacifier. The cap, okay, the nipple, I've just forgot to get it. I'll just get it. Yeah, so here I have the nipple also. Please note that you do not have to
put any brush in the nipple because it can corrode it. So just put the nipple and hold it from here. Don't hold the nipple like this. Because we need, you know, the nipple, that is the part which goes in the baby's mouth, to be as bacteria free and clean as possible. So we hold it like this and we place it here. And that's it. We close the lid of the steamer. And here's the button. We just press it and the red light goes. It goes on for 6 minutes. And voila, the bottles are sterilized. So I suggest, if you are using bottles, please clean them first. Sterilize them. A lot of you have asked me that, you know, whether we can directly sterilize. No, you need to clean them first, and every time after every use you need to sterilize them. And even while after the steamer is done and when you make the bottle, please clean your hands first, wash them with soap or sanitize them. And while making the bottle, make sure again you don't hold the nipple like this, instead hold it by the rim. Remember that for formula milk, whenever you put it in the bottles after usage, you cannot let it stay for more than 1 hour. 1 hour is the max. Please discard it after that. And if your baby's taking breaks between having milk from a bottle, please put the lid back on, because so on the nipple the baby's saliva is there, and which becomes a home for bacteria to foster. So that is what we don't want, and which is why we sterilize. So please take all these measures to give your baby an infection-free feeding time. Thank you. Bye-bye.